time for the second of our clips of the year. We've got another, we've got 11 for you here, blimey. So, we start off with Alan, don't we, Andy?
That's right.
And one thing you can say about Alan, he's a great teller of a gag, isn't
he? Oh, yeah.
Well, someone told me yesterday what a wasp and a swarm's got in common. Something like, what was the answer now? It was something like, wasp and Aussies in common, you know, they're both, what do they do in this world? You know, these bees make honey, you know, they're here for what purpose? Just a waste of time, the both of them. He was a right grumpy old sod, he was.
He did that old alternative comedian's trick, didn't go well, so he swore.
Yeah. Right. It was quite odd, but he had a sort of one of those wobble balls in there with him.
This is pure beaky, isn't it?
This is, yeah. Who was he talking to again?
Chris Ekibusi.
Chris, you've obviously been in World Championships, Olympic Games, European Championships, and when you go out there, by and large, you're on your own. Even if you're in a relay team, you're on your own. There's no mates around you can pass the baton to.
Well, Chris, let's be honest. If there's any point in Chris Akabusi's day when there is someone to pass a baton to, it's in the relay race.
Absolutely right, yeah. And, you know, I'm a big fan of Mike Mendoza's work.
Yeah.
And it's very show busy. The last hour is very show busy. And Christopher Biggins and Lionel Blair popped in. And,
didn't they really?
Yeah. This is what they said.
Hi, this is Lionel Blair, and you're listening to Mike Mendoza, or you had better be listening to Mike Mendoza on Talk Sport.
There we are.
That wasn't the clip.
But
nothing better than a trail from Lionel Blair. He doesn't do them for us.
We'll find it for you later on. But that was good to hear it, though.
Oh, tremendous. Well, we've got the others.
Now, I'll tell you what, in all seriousness, let's be serious for a moment.
Oh, yeah.
Mike Parry was very ill this year.
He was.
And we said very Merry Christmas to him when we did Andover earlier on. And there probably were points this year where Mike didn't think he'd see Christmas. So we're all delighted he did.
That's right.
And it was great to have him back. That said, it's great to have the clips as well.
Sure.
And he came back the first couple of weeks and returning with Ian Collins, his fine show from 10 here on TalkSport. He gave us this comment on Band-Aid.
For some people, it'll always be an event that happened in 1985 at the height of Band-Aid and Bob Geldof and everything else. Why have you decided now to put icing on that image, which for many people won't be icing, but really rather sour-tasting butterscotch?
Oh, yes. I hate that. It's like bitter candy philosophy.
It's not easy to buy.
No.
Uncle Joe's don't make it.
That's right. So this is a caller to breakfast, and I don't know, let's just hear what he or she had to say.
Yeah. From Camp Lescott down to Plymouth and Louise. Hi, Louise. Morning.
Troy Lewis.
Oh, sorry.
Johnny Lewis. Still was a woman.
I'm halfway through the operation.
Hello.
That's right, yeah. Babs Cabs.
Of course, Alan's doing a travel show, isn't he?
I look forward to that.
Yeah,
that'd
and
brilliant,
we all know what his favourite destination is, don't we?
It's his island of his dreams.
Tim, just a quickie, have you been in the beautiful part of Brazil? I think it's an island off São Paulo, Búzios. Have you been there, the chance to get there yet?
Oh, yes, there we are. That's an answer. But the idea, it wouldn't be great if someone, I don't know, Ryanair decided to fly direct to Búzios for $9.99. Just do a cheap one.
Yeah.
Well, 2 pence to get to Búzios.
Now, the Olympics, we all cast our mind. What a great time it was, wasn't it?
Brilliant.
Kelly Holmes, it was tremendous, the Coxless Fours. But for me, the moment of the Olympics was this, Beaky and Alan commentating off TV on the Olympic kayak final.
Yeah.
But Tim Brabant really pushing hard, and he's now right into the second place rower in that event, the second place paddler. So he's about to take second place, but will the line come too quickly
for him?
Go on,
Tim.
Keep going. Keep pushing on, and I think that it might be too much for him to get to the line to get a gold. Here's the finishing line coming up. He might just get a silver if he pushes on, will he? Is it a silver? We'll confirm that with you in just a moment. Or indeed, he might not. I might have been looking actually at the two up at the top there. In fact, he didn't get into the show there, so my apologies for that altogether. We're looking at
that was exciting.
It was exciting.
Unfortunately, you were talking about the guy from Azerbaijan.
What a tune.
Azerbaijan.
He was going to be awesome.
He certainly does. So there we are. Now, this was a caller to Mike Dickin, and it gave him a chance to both pay tribute to the great Abbott and Costello, didn't it?
Mm. Derek's on the wheel. Where are you going, Derek?
Hello.
Hi, Derek.
Hi, Derek. Hi.
No, I'm Derek. No, you're Derek.
I'm Derek.
You've got me confused, huh?
Derek.
Yeah. No.
Well, Derek, just to let you know.
No, I'm not Derek. You're Derek. I'm Mike.
You're Mike, sorry.
Right.
Yeah. He's still calling himself Mike.
Who's on first? So...
And this was Mike speaking to, of course, we loved Mike and Alan in Portugal.
Brilliant, Euro 2004.
And they really did have some top guests, didn't they? And he got this guy on and asked him a question and then basically answered it.
Hmm. So, I have with me now a young man, João Paulo Almeida. What a name, eh, for a Portuguese football fan of Benfica. Concierge in our hotel here. When you take on England on Thursday, I don't need to ask you this question, but who's the man you most fear from England?
Probably
Wayne Rooney.
Probably, yes.
Whatever you say, Mike.
I don't have to answer this question. I need to answer it, but I don't need to ask.
I tell you, when I want to know about football, I always go to the concierge.
That's it.
They know everything.
They do. They know. They get you a good restaurant, get you a cab, and they tell you who's going to win the game. Now, this was Beaking. Like you, Anne, he likes to bring it back to sport.
Mm.
But here he is on the US elections. Then he brought this back to sport.
Do you actually care what is going on over there in the United States of America? Does it matter to you? How do you think it might affect the next election here in this country? How will it affect the Champions League tonight, Al?
The US elections, yeah. Well, and, you know, if he does lose Bush, it could have a bad effect on Chelsea.
I think Chelsea are very unhappy about John Kerry.
That's right.
So this was Millwall did well, didn't they, to get to the cup final?
Yeah,
they
did.
Tremendous. Delighted, though. And one fan was so overjoyed, he called Steve Jones on the... Yeah. I think it was just after the cup final.
He was an Italian guy, wasn't he?
He was, yeah.
Francesco, could I say grazie for that?
Yeah, grazie anche a te. Grosso abbraccio e... But in bocca al lupo, that means good luck to Millwall for the UEFA Cup next season. And God bless everybody at TalkSport, fantastic station. And I hope everybody in football in general enjoyed the FA Cup final today. As myself, as a neutral supporter, we had a great day, lovely day. The sun was out and everybody had a great day.
Such an expressive language. Your sentence was all that.
Bocalubo, and it means all that. Fantastic. You're UEFA Cup. Everyone at TalkSport. Have a great summer. So, and finally, this is one of our favourites of the year. These are some of these clips of this year. This is Ian Collins. Mm. And he had Mike Rutherford, formerly of Genesis, on the show. And they had a caller.
We're going to take some calls. Mike Rutherford is with us from Mike and the Mechanics. 08704 2020. This is Mark, who's down in London. Mark.
Hello, Ian.
Hi, you're through to Mike.
Good evening.
Hi.
Hello, Mike.
How are you doing?
Seen you several times.
Right.
Hamburg, Manchester and Birmingham.
That's good.
That was in the 70s when Phil Collins was on the drums.
Right.
Now, a question I've got to ask you is, how did you come out with the Salisbury Hill? Where did that come from? Because that was a brilliant, one of the best songs I've ever heard.
Right. Well, unfortunately, that wasn't me. That was a song by Peter Gabriel.
But it was Peter, yeah, but weren't you involved in that?
No, that was his first real kind of solo album he did when he left Genesis. But, I mean, I agree. I think it's a great song.
I've seen Genesis live several times. And they're one of the greatest sounding bands I've ever seen in my life. What do you think of Supertramp?
Just gets better, doesn't it?
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
It's got his own show,
though. Well, there we are. They were the clips of the year. We've got some more Clips Gold featuring a bit of Keith Arthur, a bit more Beak, a bit of Mike, a bit of Dutch Holland going to a party, and that Arthur Orbiston clip about Antinomy, all coming up in the next section. But we're going to catch up with Todd Macklin very, very shortly, talk more to our listeners in the studio. It's the Hawksby and Jacobs Christmas Eve party. Patrick and Tone, of course, will follow us with the game at 4.